Hello everyone, my name is Nguyễn Khánh Hoàng. Today I will present about our work Rich Genetic Place, a benchmark dataset for automatic segmentation and labeling of individual ribs on genetic race in middle 2021. So this is my contents. Rib segmentation is an important prerequisite for bone suppression, which aim to minimize the impact of the superposition link structure like the ribs and clavicle on the lung fields. Additionally, the location of the ribs is used as an anatomical reference to identify several lung lesions or sometimes to perform surgical intervention. The traditional approach using handcraft feature can segment the posterior ribs. However, they fail to identify anterior ribs and also it's hard to distinguish individual ribs. The development of deep learning make remarkable progress on this task. However, there is no publicity datasets for automatically segmenting individual ribs for both anterior and posterior. Therefore, we introduce dataset Rib Genetic Trace. It contains 245 AP and PA genetic trace images, and also X image is segmented individual ribs at pixel level manually using web by labeling tool VinLabs. X image has 20 labels from right ribs 1 to right ribs 10 and left ribs 1 to left ribs 10. And to develop a segmentation algorithm, we split the dataset to 196 images for training and 49 images for evaluation. This image is from our web-based labeling tool, VinLab. In this work, we deploy four state-of-the-art model, that is UNET, UNET which EfficientNet B0 as encoder, Feature Pyramidal Network which EfficientNet B0 as encoder, and Tested UNET which EfficientNet B0 as encoder. For further detailed implementation, please read the paper. To evaluate the performance of the model, we use four metrics, that is dice score, 90% house drop distance, sensitivity, and specificity. We also try to infer the outputs in ZSRT and Zen dataset. In this table, you can see that UNET plus with EfficientNet B0 backbone get the highest dice score, which is 83.4%, and this is the output of our model. As you can see, that the model works well on both normal image and abnormal image, and also we can see that our model is then the right well in Shenzhen dataset and ZSRT dataset. Thank you for your listening. I'm happy to answer your question.